So, with dear children, let us once again begin with this discussion ahead. With the revision part, we were focusing upon the day. We were further to discuss the case of our work energy theorem beta. Let us quickly proceed with this work energy theorem beta. Regarding this work energy theorem beta, we will be having this discussed as such. That work done is equal to the change in the kinetic energy. Work energy theorem. Work energy theorem, it states that work done is equal to the change in the kinetic energy. The change in the kinetic energy. In order to have the proof of this relationship, we can furthermore have this discussed as such that our work done is in the case of a moving object. Imagine this is the horizontal surface with us. On this horizontal surface, imagine this toy car, and this toy car is moving with the velocity, say small u, in the beginning beta. And when this toy car is moving with small u initial velocity, small m is the mass, a is the point where this object is moving, and this toy car is moving along this straight road reaching up to point B. This is the velocity v, s is the distance covered by this toy car. And in this case beta, we will say that when a force F will be applied on this toy car in the direction of the distance covered, this work done W is equal to F vector dot S vector, or simply it is equal to F into S, because force and distance covered, these are in the same direction. Work done, this is equal to your F on account of being equal to MA, it will be M into A into S beta. So I can substitute for this M into A from our Newton's law over here for the force. Work done, this is then MAS, I will call this as equation number one. Let us take third equation, B square minus U square 2AS, U is equal to your initial velocity, and V is your final velocity. Let us take acceleration as small a, because velocity is changing from small u to v, and the distance covered is s already given to us. I will be calculating as from here. As will be equal to 1 by 2 into v square minus u square, and let us substitute this as in this equation. I will get work done is equal to m into 1 by 2 v square minus u square, and furthermore m can be taken into the bracket. This is 1 by 2 m v square minus 1 by 2 m u square, or you simply say that work done is equal to change in the kinetic energy. So this is our work energy theorem. Again, if I go for with the repetition of the steps, I will simply be saying that work done is equal to the change in the kinetic energy. We imagine an object moving on the horizontal road with initial velocity small u, having a mass small m initially at the point A. Then we apply a force F on this object. The object reaches up to point B and its velocity changes from small u up to this value small v. And furthermore, beta, the work done by this force can be calculated by W to be equal to F into S theta. Or F is equal to your M into A, M into A. It can be substituted from third equation of motion. And when we substitute M into A from the third equation, we will automatically get calculated our work energy theorem, that work done is equal to beta change in the kinetic energy. So dear children, in this way, we can say that we can have our energy and work related in the work energy theorem. And furthermore, we have it in this manner continuation with the discussion ahead with the topic power beta. Let us focus upon the concept of power and what do we mean by this term power and how we can calculate this power. Let us proceed with this discussion. Power beta is basically power. It is defined as the rate at which work is done, or we call that power is the rate of doing work. In order to have the mathematical interpretation of the same, power is equal to the work done per unit time, and the power in SI units, it is in between watts, and after watts, the other available units are kilowatt, megawatt, even horsepower is one of the most important units of our power beta. So dear children, in this way, we can say that the power of a source is called to be 1 watt if 1 joule of work is being done in 1 second. This is the defining part. If some agent is doing 1 joule of work in 1 second, we say that the power of that agent is equal to 1 watt. And dear all, 1 kilowatt is equal to 1000 watt. This is another relationship. 1 megawatt, this is equal to 10^6 watts. And with 1 horsepower, this is 746 watts. Keep all these relationships in your mind. And finally speaking, beta, we sometimes need to calculate electric energy consumed, beta. Electric energy, beta, E, this is equal to power into time. Generally, during the calculation of the electric energy, power, beta, it is taken in kilowatts, time is taken in beta hours. Or we can say that 1 kilowatt hour, this is a power of 1 kilowatt being used for 1 hour beta. Over here, 1 kilowatt is also called 1 unit beta. So we can say that 1 unit is equal to 1 kilowatt is 1000 watts, and 1 hour, this is 60 into 60 seconds. This is equal to 3.6 into 10 raised per 3, 10 raised per 6 joules beta. Watt into second, this is equal to joules beta. So beta, dear children, in this manner, sometimes we may be asked to relate our 1 kilowatt hour with beta joules, that how many joules will be there. So 1 kilowatt hour is 3.6 into 10 raised per 6 joules beta. So this is how you can get the relation between the two completed in this manner. Now, beta, towards the finish of this chapter, rather, we have almost finished this chapter. I will be once again at this point, beta, relating this work done and the power in another form. Let us have this, beta, form discussed. Electric or mechanical power, whatever type of power we are talking about, this power P, this is equal to work done upon time taken. Work done is your force into distance covered upon time taken. This is well known to us. We have derived it so many times. This distance covered upon time taken, this is with a equal to your velocity v. So power is equal to F into V. This is just another expression for the power. And if we take into account over here the dot product also, power will be equal to F S cos of angle theta between the two divided by T. This S upon T, it will give you beta V F S H. Distance covered upon time taken is speed or the velocity. And cos of angle theta, this is SH. So these three possible expressions for the power, these may also be put to use with it. So in this manner, beta, once again, the power of a source, it is defined as the rate at which work is done, and work done is equal to force into distance covered upon time taken. Distance covered upon time taken is equal to velocity. Your power will be equal to force into velocity. And also, beta, if we take into account this expression of the work done, that is, it is F into S into cos of angle theta, S upon T, it will give you beta speed, power will be equal to F into V into cos of angle theta, beta. So in this manner, we can relate the electric power or the mechanical power, either with the force or velocity, or with the work done or the time taken. Along with this theta also, if you have the force applied at some angle with respect to the horizontal and all that. Now, beta, let me focus upon one numerical problem related to your mechanical power. Suppose, beta, we have the statement like that, beta, a buoy of mass 50 kg runs up a staircase of height 10 meters in 8 seconds. Calculate the power delivered by the buoy. Power calculate jo hai, that is required. Power is equal to work done per unit time. This is well known to us, beta. And work done W, this is equal to M into G into H upon T. And in this case, mass of the buoy, this is given to be 50 kg. G is 10, H is 10, time is 8 seconds. So I will have mass 50 kilogram, G is 10, and height H, this is again given to be 10 meters. Let us substitute these values. M into G into H is there, and the time taken is 8 seconds. So this is 5000 over 8. You can solve this further. If I take it in decimal points, it will be 625, I think. Watch. So, okay, thank you all. The time is up. Bell has gone. We will be meeting again tomorrow with new discussions. Thank you all.